Hello everyone, welcome to Genius Channel. We are going to see some MBA previous year max questions. So if you see the question number 47, if sine alpha plus sine beta is equal to 0, equal to cos alpha plus cos beta, where 0 less than beta less than alpha less than 2 pi, then which one of the following is correct? If sine alpha plus sine beta is equal to 0, is equal to cos alpha plus cos beta. You have to find which of the given statements is correct. So what they have given sine alpha plus sine beta is equal to cos alpha plus cos beta, that is equal to 0. So here that means this term is 0, this term is 0. So if I'm adding the same thing, adding, squaring and adding these things, that will also be 0, isn't it? See, this term is 0. Equal to 0. So that term, if I square also, that is 0. Then this term is also, this function is also 0. This expression is also 0. So if I'm squaring that, that is 0. Then if I add two zeros, that is again 0. Okay, now what I'm going to see is, I'm going to expand this. Can you expand this? A plus B the whole square. So that is sine square alpha plus sine square beta plus 2 sine alpha sine beta plus cos square alpha plus cos square beta plus 2 cos alpha cos beta. That is equal to 0. Now what is sine square alpha plus cos square alpha? That is 1. What is sine square beta plus cos square beta? That is also 1. Then what is this? 2 sine alpha sine beta plus 2 cos alpha cos beta, isn't it? So if I take 2 common, that is sine alpha, sine beta plus cos alpha, cos beta, that is equal to 0. So here what you can do, this is 1 plus 1, 2. If I take 2 to the other side, that will become negative 2. So that is 2 sine alpha, sine beta plus cos alpha, cos beta is equal to 0 minus 2, that is negative 2. So this get cancelled, you get negative 1. Okay, now can you tell me what is sine alpha, sine beta plus cos alpha, cos beta? What is that? That is cos x minus y form, isn't it? Because we know cos x minus y is what? Cos x minus y. That is cos x minus y is sine x cos sine x sine y minus cos x cos y, isn't it? So this form we have got here, isn't it? One second, here it is plus, no? Here it is plus means that is minus here. Yeah, correct. So that will become cos alpha minus beta, that is equal to negative 1. Cos alpha minus beta is equal to negative 1, isn't it? Cos alpha minus beta is equal to negative 1. Cos alpha minus beta is equal to negative 1. So whose alpha is negative? Whose cosine is negative? Whose cosine is negative? It is pi, isn't it? Cos pi. What is cos pi? Cos pi is negative 1, isn't it? Cos pi is negative 1. So here we can write alpha plus beta is equal to pi, is equal to pi. Alpha plus beta, sorry, alpha minus beta is equal to pi. Alpha minus beta is equal to pi. Because we know cos pi is negative 1. So alpha minus beta is equal to pi. That means alpha is equal to pi plus beta. alpha is equal to pi plus beta, option B. Alpha is equal to pi plus beta, that is option B. Alpha is equal to pi plus beta, option B. Okay. Just copy down this. Any doubts? Anybody? Comment your doubts if you are having any. Okay, so now go to the question number 49. We are seeing the question number 49. Okay. If cos alpha plus cos beta plus cos gamma is equal to 0, where 0 less than alpha less than or equal to pi by 2, 0 less than beta less than or equal to pi by 2, 0 less than gamma less than or equal to pi by 2. Then, what is the value of sine alpha plus sine beta plus sine gamma? Sine alpha plus sine beta plus sine gamma. Okay, so see here what they have given, cos alpha plus cos beta plus cos gamma equal to 0. So when we add, we have to get 0. So in such kind of questions, you can just assume a value. No need of solving it, you can just assume a value. So if answer is to be 0, it can be like 0 plus 0 plus 0, isn't it? So what, whose cos cosine is 0? Cos 90 degree, or we can write it as cos pi by 2, isn't it? 90 degree is pi by 2. That is equal to 0. So alpha is equal to beta is equal to gamma is equal to pi by 2. Alpha is equal to beta is equal to gamma is equal to pi by 2. That means cos pi by 2 is 0. Isn't it? Cos alpha 0, cos beta 0, cos gamma 0. Okay. Now what you need? You need sine alpha plus sine beta plus sine gamma. So that is sine alpha. Alpha is pi by 2. Cos beta, that is sine cos pi by 2. Sorry. We have to find sine alpha, sine beta, sine gamma. That is sine pi by 2 plus sine pi by 2. So what is pi by sine pi by 2? Sine 90 degree, that is 1. So answer is 3. Option B. So, if you are getting some questions like this, you can just go for assumption, okay? No need to find out what is alpha, beta and gamma. You can put the appropriate value and then solve. Okay, so go to the question number 15. The maximum value of sine x plus pi by 5 plus cos x plus pi by 5, where x element of 0 comma pi by 2 is attained at. Maximum value of this function is attained at. So here you have to find out maximum value of this thing, isn't it? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to multiply and divide this by root 2. Remember, certain questions you have to multiply and divide something. So this is a typical question. You can mark it with a star so that you can revise before going to the exam. What I'm going to do is I'm multiplying and dividing the denominator and numerator with root 2. So this question will become root 2 into 1 by root 2 sine x plus pi by 5 plus 1 by root 2 cos x plus pi by 5. Okay, now listen, what is 1 by root 2? 1 by root 2, it is sine pi by 4, isn't it? Sine pi by 4 as well as cos pi by 4 is 1 by root 2. So can we apply that here? Can we apply that here? Yes, this I can write it as root 2 into sine x plus pi by 5 sine pi by 4 plus cos x plus pi by 5 cos pi by 4. So whose formula is this? Sine x sine y plus cos x cos y. Sine x sine y plus cos x cos y. What is that? Or one thing we'll do, we'll just, because we need sine, no? So I'm taking this as cos. Anyway, cos 1 by cos pi by 4 and sine pi by 4 are same only. So I'm writing like this. Now see, sine x cos y plus cos x sine y. That is what? That is sine x plus y, isn't it? So that is sine x plus pi by 5 plus pi by 4. See, sine x cos y plus cos x sine y, that is sine x plus y, isn't it? So now what this will become? Root 2 into sine x plus pi by 5 plus pi by 4. What do you need? You need the maximum value of this function, isn't it? Maximum value. Where is this maximum value coming? For what value of x this maximum value is coming? Now tell me, what is the maximum value of sine function? Maximum value of sine function is 1, isn't it? That is sine pi by 2. Maximum value of sine function is 1. And that is coming at which place? When sine theta. Theta is pi by 2. So this thing should be pi by 2. So x plus pi by 5 plus pi by 4 is equal to pi by 2. Now just solve, x is equal to pi by 2 minus pi by 5 minus pi by 4. What do you get? You'll be getting as pi by 20. You'll be getting as pi by 20. Option A. Understood. After reaching here, you have to check where is the sine having maximum value, because they are asking about maximum value. Sine is having maximum value where? When sine theta is pi by 2. When theta is pi by 2. So I substituted pi by 2. So I'll get the answer as pi by 20. Just take the LCM and solve. You get the answer as pi by 20. Go through. Any doubts, you can comment. Okay, so moving to the next question. Question number 51. What is the distance between the points which divide the line segment joining 4,3 and 5,7 internally and externally in the ratio 2:3? What is the distance between the points which divide the line segment joining 4,3 and 5,7 internally and externally in the ratio 2:3? So that is easy, no? Distance between the points which divide line segment joining this internally and externally. So what is the formula for finding out the point that divides this line in the ratio 2:3? Suppose one point is 4,3, another point is 5,7. We have to find a point that divides it in the ratio 2:3 internally. What is the formula? It is 2:3. What is the formula internally? M into x2 plus n into x1 by n plus n. Then m into y2 plus n into y1 by n plus n. Isn't it? Then, so this is for internally. This is for internally. Now next is for externally means, what is the formula? X is equal to mx2 minus nx1 by m minus n. Y is equal to m into y2 minus n into y1 by m minus n. Isn't it? So, apply, put here the values. So, this is when externally. So, put the values and find out. This is x1, y1, x2, y2. This is m, this is n. Just substitute the value. So, 2 into 5, 10 plus 3 into 4, 12, 10 plus 12, isn't it? So that is 22 divided by 5, 22 divided by 5, comma. Next is 2 into 7, 14 plus 3 into 3, 9, 14 plus 9, isn't it? So that is 23 by 5. So this is the point that divides internally. So this is the point that divides internally. Then externally point, what is the point externally? Just substitute the value here. M into x2, that is 2 into 7 minus. So 2 into 5 minus 3 into 4. So that is negative 2 divided by minus n. That is 2 minus 3. Which, so that is minus 1. So that will get us positive 2. That will get us positive 2. Just substitute here, okay? Nothing else is there. Just substitute in these two equations. Then next is 2 into 7, 14 minus 3 into 3. 14 minus 9, isn't it? So that is 5 divided by minus 1 is minus 5. So these are the two points that divides internally and externally. This is the point that divides internally. This is the point that divides externally. Internally and externally. Find the distance between these two points. They are asking you to find the distance between these two points. Okay, what is the distance between these two points? For that, what you can do? Distance formula, root of x2 minus x1 the whole square plus y2 minus y1 the whole square. So this is x1, y1, x2, y2. Substitute and give me the answer.
Root of x2 minus x1 the whole square plus y2 minus y1 the whole square. Root of x2 minus x1 the whole square plus y2 minus y1 the whole
Okay, so what do you get as the distance?
When you substitute here, you'll be getting the distance as
12 by 5 root 70.
12 by 5 root 70. 12 by 5 root 70. 12 by 5 root 70.
Okay, so the answer is option A. Answer is option A. Okay. So that is about today's video. We'll see in another video with more questions. Thank you, everyone.